anyways, as I was saying, yeah, it's definitely an internal, personal struggle. Something I didn't let anyone know. You know, I'd sit there for, you know, night after night, contemplate. But, you know, it's something I'm not ashamed of, because I feel like to really know yourself, you have to struggle and kind of wrestle with your personal identity to really understand who you are. And, you know, now I'm pretty sure I know who I am. You know, I'm going to continue to grow and I'm going to continue to change, but it's kind of one of those things, mm-hmm. one of my favorite quotes, when you stare into the abyss stares back into you. And now I'm very in touch with who I am emotionally. And, you know, I don't want to say I'm thankful for the experience, but it definitely helped me grow as a person.
You know what you make me feel like right now? Like when you're talking, I can imagine it feels like the exposure of the authentic human animal and what really goes inside every human being. Because we probably have never understood ourselves completely in an authentic level. Nobody did. Everybody thinks they do.
Oh, Buddha.
You see what I'm saying? Everybody thinks they do, but nobody, I don't think anybody have ever completely understood themselves. Because this is a continuous growing process, man. It's funny because, you know, we go in the world, you know, kill it in life, do this and that. When you break it down, make that person sit here and then strip him out of his clothes and his personality, go deep inside the soul and, you know, what makes that person, what are the things that happened that shaped that person to what that person has become. There's a lot of dark things that comes out. And, you know, there's a quote that says, the human animal is the most vicious creature in the entire world. Would you say that? What would you think?
I can agree with that. We definitely have the potential to be. Whether it's to other animals or to each other, you know, or to ourselves, humans can be very vicious sometimes.
Very vicious sometimes. And, you know, seeing you, man, all the things that you said, you struggled with suicide, you struggled with anxiety, you did this and that, you were overweight. You know, nobody can just imagine by seeing you right now what overweight means. And going to medical school. What would you say for the next generation that are coming in? Not in medical school, in general, that the next generation are after us that are going to come in the marketplace, or, you know, people are going to go to school. What do they need to be aware of in terms of a healthy life?
Just never forget that, you know, no matter how stressed and how busy you get, you need to take care of yourself.
Take care of yourself, what do you mean by taking care of? Like, what are the...
Well, there's many different facets of that as far as your mental health and your physical health. If you're having problems, if you're stressed, if you're depressed...
You need to ask God for help for your mental health.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't have to be professional. If you have a good support system, if you have a good close family, close-knit family, someone you can talk to, or a really good friend, someone, you know, that you can really be open and honest with. And that's where it comes to. You have to find someone that you can be open and honest with and trust.
How can people find somebody like that?
Well, if you don't have anyone that you've developed a relationship with over many, many years, then finding the right health professional is the best way to do that. You know, I was really skeptical. You know, I'd been to a couple counselors, and I was like, no, this is not for me. But when you find the right one, it definitely makes an impact. You know, if you find the right counselor, someone that you can talk to and be open and honest with, that's all it takes. And you got to remember, if you're going to counseling, they're working for you. You're paying them. And it's completely all right to shop around. You know, if you meet with a counselor and you really don't like them,
well, just move on.
Just move on.
It's like life.
Yeah, if they give you a bad feeling, just move on. It's no big deal. No one, they're not going to be mad at you. Just tell them I'm sorry.
You're not for me.
Yeah, this isn't for me. I'm going to, you know, do my own thing and just find a different
thing. Don't ever, basically what you're saying is don't ever get stuck in one thing. Mm-hmm. Keep on moving. Life is about a journey.
Yeah, it's all about change and adapting. So if something's not working for you, if you're unhappy, then you need to change and adapt.
That goes for every single department in your life, right?
Everything.
Don't get stuck. Move on. Yeah. Move forward.
Keep trucking.
Keep on moving.
Yeah. And a huge problem, people just kind of lose their motivation for life, you know?
Why do people lose motivation in life? What would you say?
You know, it's different for every person.
Yeah.
But as for myself, when I'd kind of lost my motivation for life, it's because I didn't have any goals.
Absolutely. I agree with you 100%.
And if I did have a goal, it was this huge outline goal that I wanted to accomplish, but I had no path to get there.
Maybe more of a purpose. Not just goal, because goals can't change. Maybe you have 2-3 goals. Yeah. Maybe like purpose in life.
And definitely, you know, in the difference between a goal and a purpose is much more personal. It's almost like a spiritual thing. Mm. But, you know, I'm very, very goal-driven. Mm. And what I've done to help myself was set all these small goals. Mm. And all of them lead up to and culminate into my end goal. So,
okay, let me dissect that so that you understand I'm getting the point here.
Okay.
So you have one major goal and you dissected it to 3-4 goals, right? And then all of those goals or those activities leads to that one thing.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you're saying?
Yep.
Okay. Yeah.
So everything that I try to do is always a step towards my goal. And
for example, if somebody wants to help, like, completely take care of their health, that's the main goal, right? Or like be a strong version of themselves. Then the small dissections of that huge goal would be take care of your mental health, take care of your food, exercise, take care of your hormones, meditate. All this leads to this one path, right?
Yeah. I'm glad you brought up meditation because I'm actually a huge fan of meditation. I don't meditate in a traditional sense, but there's an exercise of where you just sit down for 5 minutes.
Yeah.
And well, you start out as 5 minutes, and you increase your time as you get better. And you sit there, and the goal is to think of nothing.
Dude, I do that. I meditate because I look hyper, right?
Yeah, you're pretty.
I'm very hyper.
Energetic guy.
Some people might think that this guy is always hyper. And I was way, way, way hyper when I was going to school. It was much worse. It mellowed down a little bit right now. I'm getting a hold of it, but I get excited and I'm fast. I'm moving. Like, I go so fast that there's nobody beside me. Makes sense.
You might have ADHD, whereas I just have ADD. I'm a very relaxed, chill person, you know. So we're very, not conflicting, but very different.
Very different in terms of, you know, the dynamic.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know that you're very chill and you can see. I cannot sit here without moving my hand. You know, it's automatically moving. And a lot of people might think, there are a couple of videos that I made just ranting out. Basically, the videos that I make is my way of expression, self-expression.
Mm-hmm.
I'm breaking free some of the rules, some of the old rules that have been given to us by the generation that's outdated. This is the new generation and it's me, the 21st century. And I'm going to push through some noise. So sometimes I rant out because I'm always hyper. I would get excited and I would like, yeah, this is this. And then I realize after later on that, oh, hey, chill. Relax. Not everybody's as hyper as you are. Take a step back, maybe take a break. just detach from the noise, come back to center, and my center is my purpose. Because I start running so fast. This exact same thing somebody else said. Hey man, I think you have ADHD. And I laughed at him and I was like, I don't know, I don't care. I think it's working out for me. But I think I'm, and because they said that, hey man, there's a medicine that will help you mellow down a little bit, you know, focus a little bit. I have a horrible focus. I don't know how I get the things done, the things that I do. But beside the point, would you say as a physician that it's very important for you to come back to center, take a break, detach from the world? Because inside, you know, you have a purpose. And sometimes when doing a lot of things together and, you know, mixing with a lot of different clients and friends and this and that, you get blown away from your path. Does it make sense? Did anything make sense to you?
No, I understand what you're saying. You know, if you have a lot of things going on at once, if, you know, you are stressed, under pressure.
But, for example, if somebody likes being under pressure.
Which, myself, you know, I...
You like being under pressure?
I thrive under pressure.
Oh, dude, give me five.
Pressure makes diamonds, man.
Dude, you wouldn't believe, but I did not know this about you. But me, I do really good in pressure. Like, for example, there was this meeting with some high-profile clients that other day. You know, like, top-notch venture capitalists down in Dallas, right? And I was this small 5'6" I don't know my exact height. Never checked it, but I'm short in general, right? I walked in, there was this group of people. You know, like serious looking, all suited up. There was something serious about to happen. And I thrived. I killed it. I killed it because they could not, because I'm hyper. When it's this situation is stressful, I get more hyper. And then it just overlaps anybody else's topic. It's me. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Does that happen to you?
You know, I wouldn't say I get hyper, but I get very... I get very focused.
You get focused.
Yeah, you know, I have that problem with attention, you know, the ADD and stuff. But when I'm under pressure, my mind just focuses. So I have infamous test-taking skills.
Oh, shit.
Like, I know, I don't have to study. I can just sit down and just kill a test. So I've
Dude, people will pay to get that from you.
It's a talent, definitely, you know. A lot of people I go to school with, you know, I'm a chemistry, biology double major. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of tests. They're always really hard. A lot of people get test anxiety because some of the tests are so important. They're weighted so heavily in your grade. You know, they're freaking out. And I'm just, you know, just chill, relax, and just focus.
God.
The same way I took the MCAT. The MCAT was the most important test I've ever taken in my life.
Killed it.
Yeah, I did very well on it. You know, I sat down and just went at it, you know. Was I nervous and stressed before? Yeah. But as soon as I sat down in front of that test, in front of the computer, it all went away. And I was there. I had found my center, dude, and it was that test.
Oh, my God. I can relate to exactly what you're saying. Man, I was sweating, literally, okay,
yeah,
before that meeting. And I walked in because I was nervous. I got more hyper, and I was like... We're here, it's ready, we're about to start the meeting. Are you guys ready or not? And they were like, who the hell is this guy? You know what I'm saying? Let's roll. I start explaining, this is what it is. I'm sure you guys have researched on me and the company right here. We have this product, let's roll with it. Are you guys interested? Bam, 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 bam. I got a hyper, and it just came on naturally. You know, I started using my hand, I started shouting, and they were like, man, this guy is confident. I don't know if it's confidence or not. Maybe they don't know what's happening.
They might take it as confidence.
They might take it as confidence, but
I'm
because of the ADHD might be. It might be because of that. You know, I operate like that. I get something turns on, and I was like, and we just figured out something that is valuable too. Like, despite of all the things that we do, we have something like quality.
Under pressure,
yeah,
like, our focus is good.
Love pressure.
What was your meeting about?
Dude, we... Oh, man. raising capital for a huge client that is about to invest for real estate. You know, Dallas is booming in terms of apartments, like high-rise apartments. Mm-hmm. And we got this, we were talking to this, I met this man who I went to pitch for my business, and then we started talking about his business, and he said, hey, man, we have a meeting. And I said, hey, man, I think I can raise some capital for you. Would you give me if I do that, how much would you, we had a transaction, like if I raise capital for him, then he would in return buy a stock of my products. Like he would buy a wholesale, he would buy it in wholesale. That would be a huge sale for me. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I knew this other person that was going with him. So he said, hey, come with us. Because I understood how to, what kind of pitch we need to construct because of that investment. Because, you know, big venture capitalists, they don't give a shit about, you know, they want to have returns on investment. So he said, hey, man, you understand this business and, you know, you understand how to pitch and you have this weird sense of shamelessness, if I'm at the same, you know, I'm shameless in front of.
You're direct, you're honest.
I'm direct, straightforward, on the face, specifically if it's stressful. Mm-hmm. Because I lose it. I'm on, because I don't know, it might be that because I'm stressed. I know that there's a lot at stake. I know that there's high stakes on those kind of meetings, on those kind of interactions. It's a short period of time, high stakes, pitch, yes or no, done. And those people, they love somebody who's aggressive, who's right in time, on point, does not waste any time.
That's what you're talking about. You're just straight with them?
Yeah.
You shoot them straight, yeah.
And I think I figured that out by looking at a lot of extremely successful people. They hate wasting time. They want somebody to take control. So in any high power meeting, everybody's waiting for somebody to take the control. This is where I come in. This weird guy who's short and, you know, I mean, he's smiling. He's like, there is an authenticity about it. Does it make sense?
Yeah, you know what? The meeting you had sounds almost exactly like how my last medical school interview went at OSU. You know, I was extremely stressed.
Yeah.
And I felt like I was on the verge of throwing up before I walked in.
Yeah, there is this gut, like something goes on in your stomach, like, oh, shit.
And you're like, oh, my gosh. You know, you're just kind of hyperventilating. Your pulse is crazy. But as soon as I walked in and sat down, it was just, you know, I was very, very confident, very direct.
Very direct, like smitting, maintaining mm-hmm. eye contact. Mm-hmm. High-profile clients looked at me and like they really thought I was a big shot. I was like, "This, who the hell is this guy?" Yeah.
That's all it takes, you know, is just being confident in yourself and direct, you know. And I was concise, and you know, we ended up having a great time in our interview. It was so much fun, and it was, you know, the whole pressure makes diamonds. You know, it's my fight or flight instinct. You know, the autonomic nervous system is like, this is an important moment. It's time for me to kick in and fight. You know, not fight in a literal sense, but fight as in.
I mean, that focus, response, that focus.
Yeah, that mental focus was the response.
Go all in.
Yeah, because my subconscious, my autonomic nervous system knew that's what I needed to do and needed to be successful. And, I think that's all it takes is being able to at least pretend confidence, you know, at least fake it. But it's definitely, it'll change things.
Okay.